So after the amazing sessions by Christoph, Herb, and Brian, we are now at the last session of the connected development track. Next, we have Anna, developer advocate at Amadeus, and she will be talking about why you need a developer relations team for your API. This also tees up quite well with the first session and the Q&A, which we had with Christoph, and why the DevRel role is really hot in the industry as well. So really delighted to present Anna and about her talk. So Anna, really warm welcome to you, and
thank you.
Please take the stage and share your valuable insights with your audiences. Thank you.
Perfect. Thank you very much. Can you see my screen?
Yes, we can. Perfect.
So first of all, thank you everyone for joining today's presentation. Before introducing myself, I would like to share a small story with you. So around 3 years ago, my best friend and I decided to build a blog website in order to share our articles and our stories. And we wanted to use some analytics API in order to be able to identify the traffic and the visitors that were reading our stories. And so we decided to use one specific API provider that had good services and good technology. But since the very beginning, we didn't have a very good developer experience because the documentation was not very clear. There were not enough guides and tutorials to help us get started. And also, it was really hard to find some technical people to share our feedback. So after spending a couple of weeks with frustration, we decided to give up and move to another API provider that was giving us what we needed. So my name is Anna Tsolakou. I work as a developer advocate at Amadeus for Developers. For the ones that you're not familiar with Amadeus, Amadeus is a leader technical provider in travel industry. And Amadeus for Developers is the open API program, which provides travel data and travel services to the developers around the world. So today I would like to talk about why you need a developer relations team in your API. And regarding the story that I mentioned at the beginning, I'm sure you have heard a lot of similar stories from many developers. And this is totally related to the market today. Actually, today there are a lot of APIs per industry. There is a very big competition with APIs that provide great technology and great services, but providing a quality API is the minimum you can offer to your customers. Your customers have many more expectations, like developer tools, tutorials and guides, even developer communities that they can share and exchange ideas and information around your product. And this is exactly where the developer relation team fits. The developer relations teams is going to bring this into a reality and make you a big player in the market. And what is a developer relations team? I'm sure you have heard a lot of times about different roles around DevRel, like developer evangelist, developer advocates, technical writers, and there is also a lot of debate out there about what is really DevRel and who all of these people belong to DevRel. And the truth is that it's all developer relations, because developer relations team is composed by diverse members with different skills and different technical backgrounds, or even different preferences. For example, some devs prefer to give public speaking, others are more comfortable in doing coding, or others prefer to write technical articles, for example. But they have some things in common. The developer relations team is all about understanding developers, how the developers feel about your product, what they try to build, and how you can help them be successful. And the DevRel team is the bridge between your customers and your product. So internally, the role of the DevRel team is to raise the voice of your customers, and externally to represent your API and be the public face. And something very important is that the developer relations members have to wear different hats. So that means that they constantly have to be involved in many different tasks, different roles, and to adapt quickly to any changes. And at Amadeus for Developers, since the beginning of our API program, we identified three main reasons why we want to have a developer relations team. The first reason is related to developer experience, how we can ensure that our customers are able to integrate easily and efficiently the APIs in their applications. And the second one is about developer community, how we can build and engage with the developer community to drive awareness and adoption of our product. And finally, is how can we provide a smooth feedback process, how we can actually take properly the feedback of the users and pass it internally in order to be able to build an attractive product roadmap for them. So today, I would like to talk about these three reasons, go deeper to each of them, and to show you how you can organize a developer relations team on top of these reasons, and also I'm going to give you some best practices. So let's talk first about developer experience. Your customers that are going to use your APIs have more expectations regarding developer tools. So they expect to have a reduced technical complexity when they want to integrate the APIs. And you can provide this by providing them SDKs. For the ones who are not familiar with SDKs, SDKs are software development kits. And to make it simple, they're developer libraries that contain all the tools and the documentation to help your users build applications in their own environment. For example, a customer who is building iOS applications is going to use an iOS SDK, for example. And through the SDKs, you can provide them a simple authorization process, also access to any of your APIs in their own programming language and environment. And finally, you can help them with error handling. So whenever they do debugging, when their application crashes, you can help them a lot by identifying quickly the errors. And we ran an example, a small experiment with a senior developer. So the senior developer made one API call without using our SDKs and then using our SDKs. And without SDK, he wrote almost 60 lines of code for the first API call, and he spent 10 minutes. And with the SDK, he wrote only 10 lines of code, and he did it just in 3 minutes. And one thing to take into consideration is that this is a senior developer, someone who is junior and is just learning how to call APIs, maybe would take much more time. And also, you have to take into consideration that your customers are not going to use only one API provider, but many more. For example, someone who is building a hotel booking application is not only going to use hotel APIs, but most probably is going to use payment APIs, map APIs to show the map, to show the hotels on the map, etc. So they're really going to appreciate if you're going to provide them these developer tools. And when it comes to documentation and guides, the documentation is the official API reference and overview that you give to your customers. And it has to be consistent and clear, especially in cases that different development teams create the documentation. It's very probable that they use different vocabulary and different ways of communication, so maybe there is lack of consistency. So the devrel team has to be there, be open to user feedback, and make sure that there is consistency and clarity across all the APIs. And also, your customers have a wide variety of experience and industry knowledge. That's why it's very important to provide them with functional and technical guides, especially for some complex APIs, or even video tutorials that you can show them a process step by step. And finally, any interesting content that could be not fully relevant with your product, but you know it might be interesting for your customers, feel free to share it with them. And to show you the power of the guides, so at the beginning of our program, we had more promotional content, but the moment the developer relations team started growing, we started providing more educational content, which reaches the 80% of the content that we share. And since we started having educational content, we started having more than 300% monthly visits. And another thing that is very important to provide to the developers is demo applications. And we believe it's important because through some demo applications, you can inspire and give ideas to your customers of what they can build using your technology. And also, this is going to reduce the onboarding process because they can even start building their idea on top of that. And finally, this is a good way for you to promote the APIs and bring awareness to the industry. And in order to do this, it's pretty simple. You just have to think of some use cases that you think could be interesting, that maybe also include some new APIs that you just released or some older APIs that are very powerful, but maybe your users are not very aware of them. And also, it's very important to publish the code. At least in our case, we see the value because, as I mentioned before, you can reduce the onboarding process. The developers can see the logic of behind the code, and also they can take some pieces of code and build their own idea on top of them. And these demo applications are very useful for customers that are early stage startups, so they have one idea, but maybe they need some more inspiration to finalize their idea, or potential customers that you can easily show them what they can build with your APIs without having to go through each API, but just by showing them some simple applications. And finally, they're even useful for some students and hackathon attendees that they want to get started easily. And to show you a couple of examples, on the left part, you can see a small application that we developed, which is related to hotel booking. So how can a user choose the best hotel for them by providing a safety information for the neighborhood around each hotel and also some attractions that the users can visit. And in the other demo application that we built, we saw the power of artificial intelligence by creating a smart flight search. So instead of sorting the flight by price, we use artificial intelligence APIs to sort the flights by the probability they're going to be chosen by the customer. And also we predict if a traveler is going to travel for holidays or for business purposes. And finally, the importance of the developer relations can be shown in customer support, because the customer support nature is mostly technical and functional. And the developer relation members have a lot of expertise in both the industry and also the APIs. So they can really be helpful whenever customers have any technical or functional questions or something about the industry. And as a good practice, it's always very good to build a framework to check frequently the health of your APIs, because you want to identify any bugs and issues before your users do. And also, your customers are not only going to reach you out through the official customer support channel, but most probably because the developers are, they live in many different online places, maybe they're going to reach you out through GitHub, Twitter, or Stack Overflow. So make sure you're active and responsive there in these channels. And finally, customer support is a great source of feedback. So not only you learn the customer ideas, the customer needs or struggles, but at the same time, you get a very good understanding of the market trends by seeing what they try to build. And now let's move to developer community. So at Amadeus for Developers, the developer community has been one of our top priorities. How are you going to build a developer community, and how are you going to engage with the community? So for that, we identified a few ways that we can do it. One of them is by attending events. And one of the type of events that we tend to attend are hackathons. Because in hackathons, there are hundreds of people that are going to learn about your API and they're going to use it. And also you get in touch with many different user profiles, for example, from junior developers to data scientists and to designers that are going to use your API. And also this is a very good way to get feedback because you are with attendees from the very beginning that they start registering in your platform until they have built their application. And also we tend to go to different conferences and meetups because it's a great chance to share our knowledge and our experience. And also we have the chance to meet with other people for networking and also, of course, take some feedback for our APIs. And we also, a few months ago, where I'm going actually to talk a bit later about it, but we built an online developer community because we're communicating with the users in many different places like Stack Overflow, emails, GitHub. So then we thought, why don't we make one single place for all the users in order to give them support and also do some networking. And finally, it's very important to embrace open source because developers, they trust open source technology. And the more active they are in the open source technology that you provide to them, the more also trust they will continue to feel and also they might do some contributions. So for example, in our case, any SDK that we built or any demo application, we make sure that is open source. And to give you some metrics about the events, we went last year. So through our developer community, we reached more than 6,000 people. We went to 21 conferences, 6 hackathons, where 2 of them were organized by Amadeus for developers, and we gave 17 talks on stage. And now let's have a look at the online developer community that I mentioned earlier. So as I said, we wanted to have a single point where all users or just people who are interested in our APIs can join this community. And so a few months ago, this is pretty new, we built the online developer community and we also made some activities in order to make it more interesting. So some of the activities that we provide are support hours where users come and they ask any questions related to our APIs. We also have some hours dedicated to networking and some discussions between us. And finally, whenever we find something interesting, like maybe a technical article that might be interesting, we make sure that we share it with the community. And since the first week, we saw really good results. Actually, we had a lot of user interactions, especially when we did the first activity around support. We were thinking that maybe no one would join. But in the end, there were a lot of users that joined and they were asking a lot of questions. So it was very interesting. And we also had one user who contributed to our SDK, another user who made a small application and he published the code using our APIs, and also a member of the community that wrote a blog article about our APIs, and we published this article on our portal. So we saw really good results and we're really happy with how the community is growing. And now let's have a look at feedback. The other reason why we believe a developer relations team is very important. So first of all, how do you collect feedback? Actually, you reach a point that after having set up the customer support channels and all the events and also the online developer community, it's very easy to gain feedback. Even if you don't go out to ask questions to the users, they come to you with a lot of feedback about new features they want to see or something that was not clear to them. Really, the engagement with the developer community is a very, very, very good source of feedback for us, and it has helped us a lot. And also, you can even send some surveys for a very specific feedback to specific customer. This is also a very good source of feedback as well. And now, one of the main challenges for us was how are we able to share the feedback that we take from the users and consolidate it. So we thought that just having one single document with all the feedback is not going to scale and is not going to be an easy solution. We decided to do some research and see what is the best for us. So we believe it's very important to invest in a tool that is going to help you consolidate feedback. In our case, we started using Trello. And every time we have some user feedback coming from customer support or the online community or some of our events, we make sure that we input this feedback in the tool. We also have some specific rules in order to label properly and tag the feedback that we receive. And also we make sure that we keep the information of the user. So then it's way easier to share the feedback with the internal development teams. And also it's way easier to prioritize the feedback with the solution that we provide. And something very important is whenever you implement a feedback that was coming from a user, make sure that you get back to the user because it is going to be very engaging. So today, we talked about the main reasons why your API program needs a developer relations team. So to recap, we talked about the developer experience that the developer relations team can contribute a lot regarding customer support, SDKs, documentation, and demo application. All of these can improve a lot the developer experience team. The developer experience. And also we talked about feedback. How can you collect the feedback and how can you share the feedback properly? Finally, we talked about the developer community regarding hackathons and events and also the online developer community. So what is the payoff and what is the outcome of that based on our own experience? We believe that you can build a happy community, a community of developers who love your product and they're going to talk about it. And also, all this is going to reduce the onboarding process. So every time you have new customers, you're going to see that it is going to be way easier and faster for them to get started. And you have to keep in mind that the more you help your customers, the more successful they're going to be. And their success is going to be your success. So the more customers they have, this is success for you and better reputation for you. And we believe that all of this is going to make you a big player in the market. So thank you very much. And let me know if you have any questions.
Thank you so much, Anna. And as a matter of fact, we do have a couple of questions because and with respect to the time constraint, we'll take it on first come, first basis. And for the remaining questions, you can drop your contact details and they can also reach out to you later as well. So the first question which we received from Phil Nash was, how does your team build and keep these software development kits and documentation up to date as the API grows?
Okay. So this is a very good question because actually it's a big challenge. So actually every time we have a new API, we try to update our SDK as soon as possible. But something that we have done in every SDK, we let the user do some arbitrary calls. So even if we haven't developed one specific endpoint, the way we have implemented the get and post methods behind the APIs, they can still use the API by using this specific method. So we always try to keep up to date our SDKs. And we also try to focus a lot on what type of languages and technology we provide, because we have to take always into consideration our resources and our knowledge. So we always hear what the customers want. That's why recently, we published iOS and Android libraries because there were a lot of users asking for that, but we wanted to find the specific time that we have the capacity to do it. So this is my answer regarding that.
Thank you so much, Anna. And since we are almost out of time, so I would like to take this opportunity to thank you again. It was a pleasure.
Thank you very much.
As a speaker and sharing all your insights, and please drop your contact details on the stage chat channel so that any further questions, the audience can reach out to you later as well. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Bye.
Bye-bye.